A federal appeals court has ruled a 75-year-old county seal in Pennsylvania can stand. It's being called a win by advocates for religious freedom. The Lehigh County seal has a cross on it, as well as a heart, silo, and other secular items. The Freedom From Religion Foundation, a group that wants to eliminate all symbols of religion from public life, sued in 2014. But Judge Thomas Hardiman, who wrote the opinion, says the Latin cross at issue here no doubt carries religious significance, but more than seven decades after its adoption, the seal has become a familiar, embedded feature of Lehigh County. Diana Verm is senior counsel for Becket, the nonprofit law firm that defended Lehigh County. Becket also defends our network. Diana, welcome back. You argued this case. Why should Americans care about this one situation in one county in Pennsylvania?
This case is important because it helps us determine who we are as Americans. Our founding fathers recognized that religion is a really important part of society, and they set up a government that doesn't impose that any one religion on people, but it also doesn't scrub religion from the public square whenever it's referenced.
The Wall Street Journal calls the Freedom From Religion Foundation, the group that sued over this, a secular busybodies. Is that an accurate representation? What do you think?
Yes. The seal had stood for over 70 years without complaint until Freedom From Religion Foundation came in from Wisconsin and said this is an establishment of religion, this is unconstitutional, and they sued over it. So the county really stood up to bullies and refused to remove it.
What do you think is next on this group's agenda? Because it can't just be about, you know, just one county seal, right?
Well, their strategy is to write letters to local governments and say this has to be removed. And so hopefully these decisions will give local governments the courage to stand up to those letters and stop being bullied. I don't know what's next for FFRF, but I hope they'll stop that strategy.
But so far, from what we can tell, it's been essentially any kind of religious reference, correct?
That's right.
So, like I said, people consider this obviously a win for religious freedom, but how overall do you think the climate of religious freedom right now is in the U.S.?
This is a win for religious freedom, and we are seeing positive steps in the Supreme Court and other parts of our government, but we're still in court defending the Little Sisters of the Poor from being forced to provide contraceptives in their health care plans. We're still defending religious adoption and foster care agencies to be able to provide ministry in the way that accords with their faith. So there's lots out there going on we're keeping an eye on.
Okay, very good. What do you think regular folks, if anything, can we do to protect religious freedom in our own societies, home, country?
Two things. One is to follow local news and keep an eye on the religious liberty cases that are out there. You can do that at beckettlaw.org. You can see what's going on our website. And second, let your local governments know what you think about this, how religion plays an important role in your life.
Okay, very good. Well, like you said, I'm glad you mentioned before the fact that there are still so many of these cases like the Little Sisters of the Poor that you guys are still fighting for and so many of the cases that are still out there. We'll continue to follow that. Diana Verm, senior counsel with Becket. Thanks so much.
Thanks, Wyatt.